understand if you're going to be a web developer. Reason being that you structure your website with your HTML. Now, as a web developer, we have two type of web developer. We have a static and we have a dynamic web developer. As a static web developer, you need to understand your HTML, you need to understand your CSS and JavaScript. There's a little bit of JavaScript. Now, what is a static website? A static website is a simple website that have a constant number of page. Also, whatever I write on the website, it's what is viewed wherever it's being viewed from. I mean that if I create a website and I put two images on the website, if you view the website in London or America or any state in Nigeria, the same thing that is showing for you, that's the same thing it will be showing for me. Unlike dynamic website, whereby, just like Facebook as an example, if I should log in my account on Facebook, the data that it's going to generate for me will be different from the data it's going to generate for you. So that's the basic difference between a static website and a dynamic website. A static website is just a simple, like e.g. a portfolio website. It has a home page, about page, contact us page, just simple page. That's a static website. So for you to be a static website or a website developer, you need to understand your HTML, your CSS, and a little bit of JavaScript. So as time goes on, I'll be teaching us other language in order to be a full stack developer. That means in order for you to be able to develop a dynamic website. So this first class, I'm going to be teaching us HTML. And I said HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It is the language you use to structure your website. In this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching us the basic tags, that tags we need to understand. Why? Because in HTML, the basic thing you need to understand in HTML is tags. If you can understand how to use your tags, then you are fine with your HTML. If you can understand how to work with the tags basically, then you are good to go with your HTML. So I'm going to be putting us through on how to work with our tags. So the first thing you need to understand is this, that just like you want to write let's say you want to type a document. What you need to do first is that you need a software where you can type your document. If you want to prepare a PowerPoint, you also need a software for you to prepare your PowerPoint. So if you want to write your HTML code, you need a software whereby you can write your HTML software HTML language. So the text editor, we call it text editor. We have Atom, we have Sublime. Basically, I'll be using Atom. You can choose to use any text editor you enjoy using. Just stick to whatever text editor that is convenient for you. But as a person, I'll be using Atom. So all you need to do to download your text editor is just go to Google, type Atom, then the first two lines you'll see Atom, just click on it, then you download it straight away. There's no config, you don't need any special configuration. But in case you're having challenge downloading Atom, you can just drop a comment under this video and I will ensure that I reply you. So another thing is this, I want you to understand that we have hundreds of videos on web development on YouTube channel. Now all these videos are good, they are awesome. I watch most of this video and I've learned so many things from these videos. But the challenge is this, you might not understand the language or you might not be able to like communicate with them, maybe because some of these guys are foreign guys, you might not have their number and things like that. So I will drop my number in the description page. After this video, you can call me, you can message me on WhatsApp, or we can do video calls. Then anything you don't understand, I can put you through. So let's start. So the first thing you need to do is this. Whenever you're writing your code, you need to like organize your code. You need to create a folder where you keep your code. You understand? Where you keep whatever you're writing. So the first thing you do is this. You go to your desktop. Then you create a folder. I've created one. That's website. Then you come to your text editor. I'm using Atom. You click on File, Open Folder. So the folder you created, the website, you select the folder. Then it's done. So the first thing you need to do is you click on Control N, That means you're creating a new file, just like you do in, what's it called, in your Word, in your PowerPoint. So I want you to understand this thing. Whenever you're creating any file, you need to have this thing at the back of your mind. If I'm creating an image file, it will end up having an extension, right? Every file you are creating on your computer must definitely have an extension. So when you're creating your HTML file, you also need to understand that you need to give it an extension so that it can be read as an HTML file. So like you're creating your Word, you need to put it in .doc. If you're creating your PowerPoint, you need to put it in .ppt, that is your PowerPoint. So also in HTML, when you are creating it, you need to put in a .html. So I'm going to be creating a file. I already press Ctrl N. So, and to create a file, just click on Ctrl S. That means I'm creating that file, I'm saving it. So your first page in whatever website you're creating must always be indexed. Reason being that if you should give it any name, by the time you are uploading it to the server, you might have challenge when you want to view the particular website and the home page is not coming forth. So whenever you're creating any website, whenever you're writing any website, the first page that your viewer will see when they type your URL, be your URL is facebook.com, the first page you must always name it index. So just like I said, the extension is going to be index.html. So you click on, you save it. You can see. So after saving it, you need to create an environment where you write your HTML code. It's very important. You can't just come and start writing, okay, welcome to my website. No. You need to create an environment for you to write your HTML. And the thing you need to do is this. If you are using a text editor, it's very simple. Once you press your HTML, it automatically creates it for you. Now, don't be scared. I'm going to put you through all this syntax. I'm going to explain what all this syntax means. Now, the first syntax here is the doc type. Now, we are basically working with HTML5. Now, here we are defining that, okay, the type of document. You know, I said something last time. I said we need to create an extension for a particular document that you're working on. So, now, after creating the extension, which is .html, we need to define the type of document we are working with. And that's this, your less than sign, your exclamation mark, then the doc type HTML, then the greater than sign. After creating this thing, let me clear this. I want you to understand something about HTML that is very, very important. In HTML, we work with tags, basically. We work with tags basically, and we always have an open tag and we also have a closing tag. Just like now, maybe I want to write I'm writing an article and I want to write heading for it. So to write an heading for it, maybe Nigeria, my country. Maybe this is the heading of my article. Now I can't just write it like this, like I'm writing a document. See, the one thing about HTML, just like I said, the HTML is used to structure your website. It tells your browser what you are writing so that it can present it like that to the user. I don't know, maybe you understand what I'm saying. Now, let me explain something to you. Now, I want to write a heading. Now, the tag for writing heading is H1. No, so Nigeria, my country. I'm saving it. So let me go back to my folder and try and view what I've written. So you just click on the, once you go to your folder, you open it. It's already showing here, but I don't want to. Okay, my browser is loading. Let's go back to the text editor. So now this is my header. I want to write a paragraph also. So like Nigeria, my beloved country, founded. Okay, let me write again. Sorry. Independent in the year 1960. first, in the line 2 here, you can see Nigeria, my country. Line 3, you can see Nigeria, my beloved country, gained independence in the year 1960. So, how is my browser going to know that, okay, the first line here, which is our line 2, is a heading? How is my browser going to know that, okay, the third line here is a paragraph? It is the tags you assign to the particular text or whatever you are doing that tells your browser, okay, oh, Mr. So-so-so and so is doing this. So that when it views it to the viewer, they can understand what you're trying to pass out. The simplest definition of a website is this. It's just like it's a collection of different files. Then you are saving it on a server whereby different people can access it. That's just the basic definition of a website. Now, if you can just think of any website, your YouTube, it contains what type of file? Video files. If you think about your Facebook, contains text, contain videos. So it's just like it's not even like it's a collection of files that you are keeping in a server. So how do your browser tells your user that, okay, this is the particular file, this is the particular document or file this man is trying to present to you? You need to put your whatever you are doing on HTML inside a particular tag. So after you've saved this, so let's go to our browser. Now let me reload it. Now you can see that Nigeria, my country, is different from Nigeria, my beloved country, gained an independence in the year 1960. Now this is the first one there. You can see that it's an heading, then the next one is a paragraph, because we use the appropriate tag. So I'm going to be showing you different type of tags we have in HTML. I'm going to be showing you how you can do a lot of cool stuff on HTML. So now, but before we start writing our code, it's important for us to do this. Now, after we've declared the type of file we are working on, that's our doc type HTML, we need to create an open tag, which is called, also called a parent tag, HTML. Let me just cancel this. So let me remove all this. So after declaring the environment, the kind of document you are working on, then you need to create a open tag. You know, basically you're going to be working with tags. Now you have an open tag and you have a closing tag. Whenever you create an open tag, you must also create a closing tag, except in some exemption, like the I'm going to be showing you some of those tags that doesn't have a closing tag. But basically, majority of the tags you're going to be working with in HTML has an open tag and it also have a closing tag. So after you've written the doc type, the next thing to do is that you write your HTML tag, the open tag and the closing tag. It's important. All the code you're going to be writing will be inside this tag. Your open tag and the closing tag. So after you've written the HTML open tag and the closing tag, now I said something the other time. I said HTML can just be likened to what gives structure to our website. It's just like a skeleton. Well, maybe let's say, okay, let's build a human being. Now the thing is this: when you want to build a human being, the first thing you do is that you need to build a skeleton, right? Then after that, you add your flesh. Then after adding flesh, you add functionality to it. So we can liken HTML, CSS, and JavaScript as this. HTML is the skeleton, CSS is the flesh, while JavaScript is the functionality, the breath, the blood that gives it life to do whatever it wants to do. So if you do not create the skeleton, you can't move to the flesh. If you don't create the flesh, then you can't move to the life. So that's why I said the basic thing you need to understand when you want to be a web developer is to understand the HTML, so that you'll be able to do cool stuff and create websites. So after you've written your open tag and your closing tag for HTML, the next thing is that just look at your body structure. There must be a head and there must be the body. So in your HTML, you must have the head and you must have the body. When you understand this concept, it becomes easy for you. So after you've written that, you just write your head. Remember, it must have a opening tag, and this is how you write your opening tag, less than sign, edge. It must also have a what? A closing tag. No, sorry, it must have a less, this is the opening tag, that's the head. Then we are going to writing the closing tag. Less than sign, forward slash, h. That's how you write your open tag and your closing tag in HTML. It's as simple as that. So all the things you're going to be writing in the head will be inside that tag. Then after you've created the head, you know, we have the head, we also have the body. The next thing is the body. So what are we going to be writing? We're going to write in our opening tag, right? Very soon I will stop writing like this. I will just, if you're using a text editor, once you click it to suggest for you, just click. But because I'm teaching us this thing, I want us to understand this thing very well. So the next thing is the closing tag, right? And body. So now let me explain these two things to you, the head and the body. Now in the head of your what are you going to be writing in the head? I want you to have this at the back of your mind. That all you'll be writing at the head, let me write it down here, all you'll be writing at the head are informations about your website. Informations about your website. These are the things that will be contained in the head. Now, the first information you're going to give whatsoever want to use your website is the title of the website. So remember what I said, anything you want to do in HTML, you need to know that you will use a tag. So the tag for writing this is TI. Just type Twitter, suggest it, click on it. So let's create a tutorial. Let's say we're creating a tutorial website. So let's save it. Now this tutorial website, the title will not be showing when a user opens the URL of your website. It won't show. But let me show you how it's going to influence whatever you've done. Now if you can look at this, my arrow, you can see that it sees slash user. So let me refresh it. You can see that it has turned to tutorial website. So that's where you keep informations about your website. Those are the things you're going to be doing in the head. You're going to be writing informations about your website. So let me try and connect my system to internet connection so that I can show us some example. Now it's connected. Let's go back to what we are doing. So that's the first tag you need to understand in the head. Then the next tag is this. After the title tag, we also have meta tags. Now as time goes on, maybe I might create a tutorial on SEO. That's what we call search engine optimization. A good website must have a good search engine optimization. What is search engine optimization? I mean, notice that you try search a website on maybe Google and you notice that it's not showing forth. The reason, because the search engine optimization have not been worked on pertaining to you've not done a good job concerning your SEO. So that's why it's not ranking on YouTube. So for your website to rank on YouTube, maybe someone like is looking for an online mall in a particular state, you just type okay, well, online mall in Kwara State. Like I also have an online mall on brm.com.ng. I run an online e-commerce in Kwara State, brm.com.ng. So maybe I am new to Kwara State and I want to check for okay, e-commerce platform in Kwara State. All I'll just do is this, I'll go to my Google and just type okay, e-commerce platform in Kwara State. Once I type e-commerce platform in Kwara State, if I've done a good job in my SEO, part of the search result that it will bring forth is VRM. I don't know what you're telling me. Maybe I know we've done this thing before. You've gone to Google and maybe you want to buy something and you're like, okay, you type shoe. Okay, where can I get shoe in Nigeria? No, I'm having okay. Let me think. I've connected with it before. Let me forget it. Let's connect and reconnect it. So it's in this meta tag that you do this. So the first thing, another thing you need to write is your description. the description about your website. Description. Sorry, description. So, in nothing less than 250 words, you're going to write a description about your website. Okay, an online tutorial website where we are learning HTML. You save it. Now, what is the importance of this? Now, when you're writing your description, you need to put key words there. When someone is searching for anything that is related to that, your website, although there is more to search engine optimization, but this is just the basic that you need to understand, and that's part of the reason why you use your meta tags. Another thing you do in the end is this: you link external files to your HTML via the head. Now, by we are going to be working with CSS, and I'm going to be showing you how you can link your external files to this, your HTML file. So, another thing, if you want to link external files to your HTML, any external file you want to link, you need to add it to the head. As time goes on, when we begin to do practicals, you'll see how we'll be doing this thing. So, but I just want you guys to get the concept. What are the things you're going to be doing in the head? That's where you keep the information about the website. You link external files to your website. Also, by the time we start working with CSS, we're going to understand some concepts when we are talking about internal styling. But that's just a gist for another class. So now let's move on. Let's save this. Now let's refresh our browser. If you refresh your browser, you notice that everything we've put in the head, none of it is showing, apart from this, which has changed the title of the website. Now, everything you put in the head is not going to show in the body of the website. What is the body of the website? These are the things that, when anybody visits your website, the things they see, those are the things that we have in the body of the website. But all the informations about the website, all the links, external links you're linking to your website, they are kept in the head. So let's go back, let's move to the body. So now when we get to the body, everything you want, whatever is viewing your website to see, these are the things you keep in the body, like the headings, the section, the article, the video, the music, the footer, the text, or the content, everything you want people to see, these are what you keep in the body. So let me just, the first thing I believe everyone should understand is, okay, your H1, like, okay, hello world. Let me save this, let me refresh my browser. So you can see it's showing on my browser, unlike the other time when I was writing in the head, nothing is showing. So please always bear this at the back of your mind, have this at the back of your mind. Whatsoever you're going to be doing in HTML, you're going to be working with tags. And I'm going to be showing us some tags, some cool tags that we're going to be working with. The first one here is H1. Now, what does your H1 stand for? H1, let me just alight. Okay, let me just comment. Now, before I move on, let me explain what comment is. Now, when you write a code, now we have different way of commenting whatever program you're writing. Now, if I comment the same way I will comment in Python, it won't show here. Why? Because we already declare that we are working with an HTML. That's why it's important for you to define the type of document you're working with, the kind of language you're going to be writing. So if I should write any syntax of HTML, maybe print hello world, it's not going to, you see, it's not giving color to what we are writing. You understand? So because I've already defined that, okay, I'm working with an HTML file. So okay, now let's move to the tags that we're going to, okay, I said I will be explaining what comment is. So the first thing you need to do is this: your less than sign, your exclamation mark, then dash dash. Then now, what do we use comment for? Comment is used to pass message not to the users of your website, but to programmers like you, and also to that, by the time you are, maybe you want to edit your website or you want to do something, you know where to go particularly to do whatever you want to do. So like, okay, let me say this is the heading of a website. Now this thing will not show. Are you getting what I'm saying? Let me save it. Let me refresh my browser. It's not showing. It's not going to show. It's just a message that you are passing. So now, for you to write heading in your website, we use this tag H1. Now we have H1 to H6. Depending on, you know, when you're writing an article, the first heading is going to be like bigger than the second one. Like, okay, the first heading will be bigger, then the next heading under that first heading will be smaller than the first heading. Let me check my video because the NEPA, okay, there's no light again. Yeah, okay. So let me continue with my video. So the first heading will be bigger than the second heading. The second heading will be bigger than the third heading. The fourth heading will be bigger than the fifth heading, and the fifth will be bigger than the sixth. We have just H1 to H6. So let me try and show you something. My name is Victor. Let me save this. Let me refresh. Can we see my name is Victor? So let me try and copy this and duplicate it. Okay, 6 times. It's 6 times. So let's say we have H2. H2. Now, let's compare the first one and the second. Can we see that the second one is smaller than this? So let's do the same thing for the other H3. And reload my browser. Can you see? After refreshing my browser, you can see that it becomes smaller. So when you're writing an heading, maybe you the first heading is my country Nigeria, just like the example I cited the other time, my country Nigeria. Then the next heading that will be under that one, you know, it will be smaller than the first one. So you are not expected to use H1. You're going to be using H2. You understand what I'm saying? So now that's on H1 to H6, that's your heading. So now let's talk on paragraph. Let me just paragraph. So, you know, after writing your heading, you need to write your whatever you're writing in your paragraph. So for you to write paragraph, you need your tag, which is RP. Then let me say I am a boy teaching HTML in front of my website, of my laptop, and having fun. Sorry, fun. Let me save this and refresh. Can you see? It's written in a format of paragraph. So let's move to something else. Okay, let me still leave the first one, the heading, just to differentiate. So your H1, I am a boy. Let me save it. So let me refresh. Can we see? So now, apart from the H1 to H2, we have other tags like now remember, all this code you're going to be writing it inside you're going to be writing it inside your body. You're going to be writing it inside the body. So after the H1 tag, the P tag, we have tags like image. Okay, don't let us go to image yet. Let's still work with some simple tag. So one thing Okay, before I go to other tags, I want you to now let me explain something to us. I want us to picture a website. When we view a website, the first thing we see on the website is that we see the logo, we see the navigation bar, we see the name of the website, we see the front image, we see some other stuffs. So now let me start from that hierarchy. It's important for you to structure your website whenever you're working on your website, whenever you're creating a website. Why? Because by the time you move to CSS and you want to apply an attribute or a property to a particular tag, maybe now, okay, let me say HTML H1, now I want to give it a color. Style. Color. I want to give it red color. My name is Victor. Now, I want you to know that, bearing it in mind that everything that we've written inside the tag will carry this color. So also, when you section your website using a particular tag, by the time you are giving an attribute in your CSS, everything you've written inside that particular section will take the attribute that you've given to it. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. So that's why it's important for us to always section whatever we're doing in our, whenever we're writing our code in HTML. So the first thing you notice is this. When you enter your website, we have the header, we have the section, and we have the footer. So by the time you enter your website, by the time you visit a website, the first thing you see is that you see your navigation bar, you see your logo, you see the front image. All those ones are in the header section. So if I'm going to write in any code, after I've written my tags, header tag, so all the codes I'm going to be writing, the navigation, the image, the logo, I'm going to be writing everything inside this header. So that by the time I want to I want every of my text in the header, I want to give it a particular font. I want them to have a particular background. Although I'm going to be teaching us div and span as we move on. But we need to also understand is that it's very important for us to section our website. So after the header, when you visit your website, after all you've seen, then the next thing you move to is the section, right? Then after the section, you can have as many sections as you want. Then after the section, the next thing is that you move to your footer. That's where you have the contact us, the address, the phone number, the newsletter, and every other thing like that. So you need to section it like this. So from there now, let's start working with some of the important tags that are in HTML. Now, when you visit the website, you see navigation, right? The navigation, home, contact us, event, and things like that. So how do you write your navigation? Remember this, you always work with the tag, right? So the tag for that is nav. Now, we need to list out the things that the home, the about us, the contact us, and different things that will be in the navigation. Now, we have two type of listing in HTML. We have the order listing and we have the unordered listing. And so for you to list out anything in HTML, you must signify whether it is an order list or an unordered list. Order list, you write OL. If it's another list, but if it's an unordered list, it will be UL. Do you understand? So let's work with. Now, what's the difference between an order list and an unordered list? Another list simply means it's going to order. It's like when it's going to it will list it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Or if you want it to be, you can determine the type you want. You can, if you want it to be an alphabet, you can determine by writing a type you want it to be. Type, then that's if you don't want it to be. So let's list out. So after you've determined if it's an another list of or an other list you're creating, the next thing you need to do is this. You need to now list out those things. And for you to list them out, you also need to work with the tag li. So let's say the first thing on our list is a table. Then the next thing, li. Book. Next thing. Pencil. Okay, so let's save it now. Can we see? Now it's in A, B, C. Now, assuming I remove the type from it. Sorry. Assuming I remove the type from it. And I save it. It's going to just bullet it. I made a mistake. I said on order. So I'm not supposed to put a type for it because it's an unorder. And another we just an unorder listing we just bullet it. It won't give you whether it's an A or B. So when we're working with ordered list, it's going to be, you know, I said order list will be OLA, right? So let's list out those things we want to. Let's say okay, shoe, clothes. What else again? Wrapper. So let's save it. Now, let's save it and refresh. See, we have one showing that this is another list. So in an order list, we will tell us, you tell the type you're working with, whether you want it to be one A. How you want it to be ordered? Is it is it Roman figure? Is it alphabet or number? You determine that. So save it. Let's check out all of that. So can you see it has changed? So after the navigation, the next thing you do is that you import image. So for you to import image in HTML, remember you must always know now. So you must you will leave the tag, come out of the tag. For you to import image img, that's the tag. Now I said something that time, I said there are some exemptions that we don't have a closing tag for them, and those exemption is image. We also have another tag called break. That's like, now let me show us how to use our break tag. Maybe p. Now I have a lot of things that I'm writing. I want to, now HTML will not, if you enter and you know on your word, once you click enter, it will move to the next. If I do the same here, it won't show like that on my browser. It will continue like that. So on HTML, for you to break your line of code, you use the tag break. So it's going to break your code. Let's check this now. The line is broken. So that's how you break your tag. That's how you break your the line code or whatever sentence you're writing in HTML. So now let's go back. Another tag that doesn't have a closing tag is horizontal row, HR. Horizontal row is, now let's write something. Let me explain how to use your horizontal row. So let me say we have our H1, I am a boy, let me say that, sorry, this is the first time I'll be doing a tutorial and I'll be recording, so you understand. So now let's say we have in our paragraph, so let's give it an horizontal rule. Horizontal rule, just from its name, it's going to rule across the browser. Can you see horizontal row? That's how you create your horizontal row when you're writing your HTML code. So now let's go back to where we stopped. So now let's import image. Now one thing you need to understand is this: when you're importing image, you can't just import image from whatever folder. You need to keep that image in that particular folder that you're working with. You know, if you remember, we created a folder, right? Created a folder website. So now let me use this particular image and put inside this folder. So you have to rename it something that you can easily remember. Don't mind me, I'm a Winners member and I'm in the studio. That's where I'm working now. That's where I'm recording this video. So that's why, and I'm making use of the studio laptop to record. So that's why you notice Winners. So after you've named it, then you come back to this. You can see that the file is there already. So all you just need to type is a.jpg. You save it, come to you. Your browser, refresh it. The image has been imported into your browser, so you can view it. So that's how you add image to it. So let's go back. Now, assuming you want to resize your image. All you just do is width. Now, the thing is this. When you are resizing your image, it's important for you to know this. If I should give it 100 pixel. Now, we either use pixel or you use percent when you're writing code. Now pixel is what is used to measure picture. Pictures are made up of tiny dots. So those dot, these are called pixel. So this is how you measure. So when we go back, it will have resized. You see, it has resized to 100%. But one thing I want you to notice is this. If I give the width 100% and I give the height 50 pixels, let me save this and refresh. You notice that the image is distorted. So just if you know you don't know the exact resolution, just provide one. It will automatically calculate it itself and it will give you what you want. So that's how to import image. That's how you're going to import your image. Also, let me show you how you can import your video. All you need is your video tag, just like the same way we put this picture inside the folder. You put this one also inside folder, then you name it the folder. Then another thing you need to remember is this: when you're writing your image, when you're adding your image, always provide your alternative. Reason being that there's sometimes that maybe you copy now. Your image is not limited to just the one in your file. You can see an image in a particular website and copy the URL link and put it here. If you try it, it will still work. So also your video, you can do the same thing here. So always put an alternative in the sense that, okay, let's put Shiloh. In the sense that if the image fails to load, let me cancel this now. If the image fails to load, let me reload this. You see, the image did not load. Now I'm coming. Wait. Okay, sorry. I already defined it twice. Shiloh. Let me save it and refresh my browser. So can you see? Even though the image is not showing, but the name of the particular image is showing there. So in case your image not show, that will cover up for it. So also your image, your video, you add the source, the autoplay. Then also it's important, you know, maybe you don't want your visitors, you just visit the website and the video just start playing. You want to have a poster image on the video. Okay, let me try and look for a video file. Let me copy this video file and put it in the folder. Let me put it here. Okay, this, let me rename it to B. So let's save it. Sorry, we don't have to save it, my brother or my sister. So let's say this is B.mkb. Right. Let's save it. Let's refresh. Coming. B dot. Okay. this is not a supported format. I'm sorry, this is not a supported format. I should either be using MP3 or to trash. It's not a supported format, but that's how you had your video. So the poster image is the image. I don't know why. If you visit YouTube now, you notice that before video start playing, you see a poster image. So this is how you had the poster image to it. And also you can add your control, like the play, the pause, and all that. That's how you had it. Once you enter this, the control will be automatically added to your video. So apart from this, you can also add music. Audio. So all you just need to do is to provide the source of your audio. Once you put it, it will be uploaded. So let's work with some other tags. You can always check W3 schools for more tags. Majorly, all you need to understand in HTML is that if you can understand that all you do in HTML is all about tags, the work becomes easy. So whenever you want to do something on HTML, just go and look for the tags, the tag you use for it. The ones you understand that this is the tag that I'm going to be using for it, just put the tag there, do whatever you want to do and it. So now let me give us the tags for button. I want to add a button to my website button. So let me name it submit, save. Let me refresh. Okay, the video is not playing well because it's not supported format, just like I said the other time. So let me, okay, I've added button submit. Okay, I'm writing it inside a closing tag of the other one. Sorry, so let me refresh it now. Can we see our button? That's how you add your button to it. So now let me, assuming you want to collect information from your user, use the input tag. So you're going to determine the kind of input. If it's an email, write your email. So the name of the, because by the time you, the reason why this is important is that by the time you start working with your PHP, this will be very useful. So let's say the name of it is email ID. So let me add another attribute that they fail to add, placeholder. This placeholder we tell whosoever is using your website that okay, it is email that should be put here. Can you see email? So by the time when you click it, my email is can you see gmail.com? Can you see? So let's say okay, oh, the input is text, just ordinary text. You leave it like that. You can password. Let's save it and check. So the password. Can you see that it's different? It's not showing it. Can you see? So view saved logins. Okay, these are things I work with it. So that's how you work with the password. So okay, there's sometimes that we might want to create a text area. Like I want them to fill a text, like drop a message. Now you can tell me how wide you want it to be. The row is 8, column is 80. So let's just check this out. Can you see? So you can write much message, as many message you want to write. That's how you do that. So basically in HTML, all you need to understand is your tags. So I'll be leaving us with an assignment that please, let's go to W3 school. Let's check for more tags. Let's work with more tags. So okay, before that, I mentioned the header. Now have it at the back of your mind that all these things, the videos, the stuff we're writing, you're not going to write it in the header. The header, just like you, when you visit your website, you see the first part, right? Then you see another section. These are just used to section. So, like, you want to add your videos, you want to add your image, you want to add the button and all those stuff. You know, you're going to be adding those things to the section. Another important tag is this, the href. That's the anchor tag. Now this tag is used to link you to external files, not just external file. Now by the time your website is going to comprise, I was talking about static website the other time. I said you're going to have up to like 5 pages, right? So by the time you want to link from this page to another page, you need to link it up. I don't really understand what I'm saying. So now okay, let's try and do something Control N. Let's try and create and say okay, page. Sorry, let me see if it's about dot html. So now I've saved it as about dot html. Now, assuming I'm working, maybe after the list of the things on our navigation bar, I have about us page and things like that. So after that, when they click on the About Us page, it should lead them to the About Us page. All I just need to do here is just to put the About dot in dot HTML. Then I'll write. About. Yeah. Let me save it. So let me go to the About Us page. Let me just write H1. About us. So let me save this and let me go back and load our site. So the About Us page, the About Us that we create, when we click on it, can you see? It leads us to another page. Let's go back. Can you see? So now you can add something like this. Now there are sometimes that when you open your right target, you get right target equals to underscore blank. So by the time you load this, let's go back, you refresh this, click on it, it's going to open it on another tab. So but in case you want to leave it on this same tab, just leave underscore self. Save it. Okay. Let's come back here. So it's going to load on the same tab. So that's that on that. And that tag is iframe. Now iframe is like you are open a new tab on another tab. Have you seen adverts and maybe you visit some websites like Niger Loaded, you just see a video. So these are iframe. And for you to write that iframe, you copy it. Copy the source code from somewhere, you just copy it, you paste it here. Once you paste it, the height. Now, one thing I want you to have a back of your mind that whenever you are defining height for pictures, image, or for video or iframe, just define one so that it will not be distorted. You understand what I'm saying? So, that's that and that. That's that and that. So, another tag I believe you should get yourself familiar with is. Another tag you should get yourself familiar with is the center tag. Okay, basically when you start working with your CSS, you might not need it, but you use it to centralize whatever you're writing. So you use it to send tracks. Maybe you want to italicize what you've done. Italicize it. Another thing is, so the super like H, I am a boy, and that tag is the SUP, that superscript, so the closing tag SUP. So you can see, let me remove the SUP for you to see it very well. Doesn't have the SUP. And let me save it. You want to have something like this. Can you see? So after, when you add the SUP, you can see. So also for subscript SUB and SUB, save it. Can you see? That's come down. So there are hundreds of tags you're going to be working with. If you permit me, okay, you can just drop a comment in the also another tag is the U tag, underline U. You want to underline what you are doing. Underline. So these are just some of the tags you're going to be working with in HTML, but you can get yourself familiarized with other tags by visiting W3 schools. You can check Google for other amazing tags, start using them, start getting yourself familiar with them. And in case you're having any challenge, just drop your comments in the comment section, and I promise to always reply you. Also, you can check for my WhatsApp contacts, my phone. Okay, I'll just leave my WhatsApp contact so that you can drop your WhatsApp message on WhatsApp. And also, if time permits us, the times that we're going to be doing video calls, in case you have you have any challenges, I can always put you through. So thank you very much for watching my first YouTube video on program HTML. So I believe to the next class I'll drop more amazing content. And from next class, we're going to be working on CSS. And I might decide to work on more tags. So thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Please subscribe and like.